Ben Sharma, Chief Guest for today's program, Professor Uday Kumar, Deans, Directors, Registrar, HODs, Faculty Members, and most importantly, our fresher students of Academic Session 2017-18 and their parents. I welcome you all to this orientation program. Orientation program, as the name suggests, provides an opportunity to the fresher students to orient themselves by getting familiarized to the institution facilities, norms and culture, academics and examination systems, and various other student services. To further give you an insight into today's program, may I invite Director Admissions, Professor Richa Arora. I also request President Manipal University Jaipur, Professor Sandeep Sancheti, Pro President Professor N.N. Sharma, Chief Guest Professor Uday Kumar, to please grace the dais. I request Registrar, Director Admissions Professor Richa Arora, to accompany the guests. I also request Dr. Adesh Kumar, Professor Rajesh Mathur, Professor V.K. Sharma to grace the dais. To give you an insight into today's orientation program, I call upon Director Admissions, Professor Richa Arora. Madam, please.
Very good morning to all present here. I would like to start with a small poem. Come in the evening or come in the morning, come when you look for or come without warning. Heartfelt welcome you will find here before you, and the oftener you come here, the more we will adore you. I would like to welcome you all, our distinguished Chief Guest Professor Uday Kumar Ji, Director MNIT, Venerable President Professor Sandeep Sancheti, Pro President Dr. N.N. Sharma, our Honourable Deans, Registrar, Faculty Members, Distinguished Guests, Parents and my dear students. It gives me immense pleasure to stand on this threshold and welcome you all to the orientation program of the new batch of students of Manipal University, Jaipur. Jaipur, popularly known as Pink City, is a land of cultural heritage, unfolding the legacy of royal past. Jaipur is a culturally vibrant city, and its culture is a rich blend of traditions and modernity, and Manipal University Jaipur, with its presence, has added a feather to the cap of this royal city, Jaipur. MUJ, Manipal University Jaipur, is a 5-star rated educational venture of Manipal Education Foundation Trust. The objective of Manipal Education Foundation is to promote educational, healthcare, and other public welfare activities, with the sole purpose of illuminating the young minds with a brighter light of education. The university is set forth to lead and unfold the brighter layers of education. The Manipal Education Group, with its heritage of excellence in higher education for over 64 years, has created an ecosystem of teaching and learning, making it a universally accepted destination by students. Setting forth the tradition of excellence in academia, MEJ is here to unfold the brighter wings of pedagogy to the budding technocrats. As the saying goes, learning gives creativity, creativity leads to thinking, thinking provides knowledge, and knowledge makes you great. I would like to congratulate all the students and their parents on their decision to choose Manipal University Jaipur for pursuing higher education and thereby opening up new vistas for a bright future for themselves. The university, along with its dedicated faculty and staff, has grown through the last 6.5 years of its existence to the immense satisfaction of the students and parents. MEJ has been able to provide excellent infrastructure and great ambience for teaching, learning and research activities. On behalf of Honorable President and Team MEJ, I welcome you all to the Manipal family with the hope that each one of you will give your best to your respective fields and specializations and bring glory to yourself and to MUJ. I would like to conclude by quoting Nelson Mandela, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. So request all the students to make use of the same and make a new beginning, as a good beginning always makes a big difference. So make sure you begin this academic session with new hopes and a positive mindset to make it a brighter chapter in your life. Thank you."
Thank you, Dr. Richard. We are privileged to have amongst us as chief guest of today's event, Professor Uday Kumar R. Yaragetti, Director, MNIT, who coincidentally happens to be the parent of one of our students. I request our president to welcome Professor Uday Kumar by presenting a floral bouquet and also honor him by presenting a memento. On an auspicious note, may I request the dignitaries on the dais to proceed to light the ceremonial lamp. I request our guest of honor, Madam Shruti Sharma, IAS and Director ICDC, to join our dignitaries for lighting the lamp. I request two of our toppers in the Manipal Joint Entrance Exam, Mr. Shashank Kumar and Ms. Ishita Joshi, to join our dignitaries for lighting the lamp. I request their guardians to join them. I invite Ms. Palak Raheja to offer invocation to Lord Ganesha in the form of a dance.
Yeah.
Thank you, Palak, and I now call upon Palak and her group for a welcome performance.
Mother.
Manipal team. It was a mesmerizing performance. These are our students of BA Psychology. I now request our President MUJ, Professor Sandeep Sancheti, for his address and to introduce the MUJ leadership to you all.
2017-18, Professor Uday Kumar Yaragatti, Director of MNIT, also the Chairman for the CSAP 2017. Other distinguished guests, members of the MUJ family, faculty and staff members, and most importantly, the new incumbents to the MUJ family, my dear students, their parents, guardians, and everyone who is present here. A very good morning to all of you. Namaskar, and a very, very warm, cordial, and hearty welcome to the portals of Manipal University Jaipur. It is a matter of great pleasure for me to welcome all our new friends to the portals of Manipal University Jaipur and to the family of Manipal Group. We popularly call ourselves as MUJ, a new generation university, which is a recipient of recognition such as Smart and the Best University Campus in India. And very happy that today many of new people are becoming a part of this family and are joining us. Friends, with your joining, we would attain an overall strength of around a little more than 7,500 students on the rolls of MUJ in a span less than 6 years. This growth has happened due to the pioneering efforts of our very distinguished Dr. T.M. Manipal, who changed the landscape of Indian higher education by way of his founding efforts in medical and technical education in particular. His legacy has been continued and strengthened by the next generation of our leaders, that is Dr. Ramdas Manipal, our Emeritus Chairperson, Dr. Ram Narayan, our current Chairperson, and Dr. Ranjan Pai, and several others. They have collectively led us towards tremendous growth and better quality in all its spheres to make us one of the finest in the country and abroad. As a result, the entire group, as well as the MUJ, has received several accolades time and again in every aspect of their work, be it teaching, research, innovation, professional recognition, or societal connect. Before I share a few words, I would like to convey my heartiest congratulations to all new and budding professionals for very well-deserved admission to engineering program and the branches of their choices. Today, you are all embarking on a new journey, a journey of your life, allowing you to explore the unexplored and control the destiny of your life. More than a decade back, when you were starting your school as a young toddler, you may have cried a little, but parents were happy that the kid has started going to the school. Today the scenario is a little different. You are happy that you come to a college education, you have a very vibrant setup, but parents may be a little sad as they will miss you, your company, and especially for those who are moving to the hostels. But I must say that it is MUJ's gain that so many young professionals are starting an important journey of their life with all of us as a companion and MUJ as a platform. We are sure the new milestones which you want to achieve, a journey of self-exploration with a quest for new knowledge to become independent and mature would soon be in your reach. Our vision is the global leadership in higher education and human development. So always remember that you have to become a very good human being before you become a very good, competent and well-deserving professional. On this special occasion of the orientation, let me first start by introducing my team to you, the team of Manipal University Jaipur, and more significantly, the leadership. Friends, I must tell you, today you are going to be supported by more than 480 faculty members, around 60% of whom have PhD qualification. That's a unique distinction this university has. But right now, I'd like to introduce to you the core leadership. I cannot do everyone, and therefore I'm restricting only to the levels of the deans and the director. I'll first begin with our chairperson, Dr. Ramdas M. Pai, who also happens to be the chairperson for almost all other for all other institutions of the Manipal group, and he has driven the growth of the university as we see today, and he was the founder chairperson of this particular institution as well. Today we have the Dr. K. Ramnarayan. After Dr. Ramdas Pai finished his term of 5 years, Dr. K. Ramnarayan is the current chairperson, is the chancellor, equivalent of chancellor for the Manipal University Jaipur. Next, I'm representing the university as the president or the vice chancellor in general parlance. We have Professor N.N. Sharma, who is the pro-president and dean faculty of engineering. May I request all of, once I name them, if they are available here in the audience, please rise and meet the new and the young budding engineers. We have Professor D.K. Sharma, who is dean research and innovation. We have Professor Mudul Shivastav, Dean Faculty of Arts and Law. We have Professor G.C. Tikkiwal, Dean Faculty of Science. We have Professor N. Chattopadhyay, Dean Faculty of Management and Commerce. I believe he has to leave for some emergent reason. We have Professor Avdesh Kumar, Dean Faculty Affairs, as well as the Provost. Professor Dr. Raj Sharma, who is the Professor Emeritus Chemical Engineering, today is not with us right now. Professor Vandana Suhag, our Registrar. Dr. Richard Sharma, Professor of English Languages and also the Director of Admission. She must have helped you with everything which brought you here. We have Dr. Rajesh Mathur, he is also Professor of Civil Engineering and also the Coordinator of First Year B.Tech. You need a lot of his guidance and support during your first year of studies. Dr. R.S. Shekhawat, Director of SCIT, School of Computers and Information Technology. Professor S.N. Sharan, Director of the School of Electrical, Electronics and Communication. Dr. Raghuveer Singh, Director of the Technology School of Business. Dr. Ravi Chaturvedi, Director of SMC, that is the School of Media and Communication. Dr. S.K. Sinha, Director of the School of Basic Sciences. Dr. Manju Singh, Director of School of Humanities and Social Sciences. She's probably not here with us today. Dr. Madhura Yadav, Director of School of Architecture and Design. We have Dr. Professor P.K. Pandey, Director of School of Planning and Design. Professor M.L. Wadera, Director of School of Business and Commerce. Professor Amit Jain, Director of School of Hotel Management. Dr. Lalita Leghwani, Director, Controller of the Examinations. Is she here, Dr. Leghwani? We have Mr. Anil Singh, Chief Warden of your hostels. And lots of others, proctors and various other coordinators, various other HODs, various other faculty members playing different roles. You'll get a chance to meet all of them today in the afternoon. Post this function and post your lunch, you're all free to go to the various parts of the campus, visit library, visit computer centers, visit any facilities or hostels, go to a sports ground, meet any faculty, we'll all be here, and post that, we'd like to interact with you once again over a cup of tea, not in a formal way, but we'll be available. The timings have been announced, the timetable has been displayed. We are all available to meet you and greet you and to make you comfortable. Friends, many of you might know that MUJ is the youngest member of the family of Manipal group, which enjoys a tremendous reputation in the arena of medical, healthcare, technical, banking, management and professional education, and is a force to reckon with within the country as well as well known globally. It also boasts of very good quality of faculty, staff and students. MUJ itself is a world class or a very high class infrastructure, be it academic or residential, and I'm sure you have started enjoying that. Very conducive for the academic pursuits, and most importantly, very good laboratories, hardware, software, and IT support system, and that is the reason we are considered as one of the very smart campus. Examples of some of the things inside the lab which will make you very happy and different from other institutions possibly would be elements of 3D printing, high-performance computing or supercomputer or semiconductor lab and things of these orders which will excite the young minds into a different orbit and make them do well. We have also been supported in this endeavor. What you see, what has been created and what has been maintained meticulously is a result of support from the various other core group agencies like Manipal and Manipal Group of Medical Education, the MAGE, Manipal Global Education, the Manipal Integrated Services, the YOHO, the Youth Hostel Grant, some of you might have seen, the Manipal Academy of Banking, the Manipal Institute of Technology, the APME, and then of course the Manipal Health Enterprise. All of them help us in some way or other because they bring the core value and deliver the good services. And through them, we are offering whatever best we can. And I'm sure you will use all these services and enjoy their support as you move along during your stay with us here in Manipal University Jaipur. Friends, although we are still in a formative stage, as I said, we have yet to complete 6 years, we have done well to create a niche for ourselves. We certainly will continue to aspire for better overall growth of the university with a focus on many new challenges of profession and society, teaching and learning, which is very important, research and innovation, which is equally important, and as well on human resource development and training, skills and practices, and so many other, you can say, the focus areas. This will all be possible with the unrelenting efforts of all of us, and from today, you are all going to join us. From today, you become part of this effort, and I'm very happy that the new generation of the students are bringing the new energy, the new and the young blood, which is getting infused in the MU today with the arrival of all of you. So once again, I take this opportunity to welcome you to this family. I'm proud to inform you that in a very short span of time, we have got several recognitions like prestigious Griha 5-star award, that's the greening of the campus, and we are the first one in the country 2 years back, we were given this award. We are the first university in the campus to achieve this distinction. We are also the best university campus award by SOCHEN, a place in Limca Book of Records by other deans and activities. LEED Platinum certification and recognition by several media houses for various reasons. And in recent times, I'd like to mention that we have received several awards and accolades which have been bestowed on us for innovation and for something good in the research and the teaching domain. And these are some of the feathers in our cap, but I'm sure you will be raring to go further and add more feathers in our cap in times to come. These recognitions are the result of an overall expansion and excellence in the key segments of our functions and activities. To support them, we have restructured our academic programs regularly and improved advancements in various fields, as well as to allow students more time for interdisciplinary activities as well as for self-studies. To support these, we have signed MOUs for collaborations with number of frontline institutions, particularly foreign, and industries to enable our students to stretch their wings globally as well as go in the desired directions. Being an engineer is fine, but you may go in any domain which you want, be it management, be it finance, be it forest conservation, be it administrative services. So we are just providing an ideal platform where you can launch yourself, and that is what you want, that while you are here with us, explore what you want to achieve in your life and move in that direction. Lots of electives, lots of other support will help you do that. Today we have a capacity to accommodate more than 5,000 students in our hostels. A well-equipped and a world-class gym is available in the hostels. The sports grounds are also available for almost all major activities and sports, but for the squash, which is being done, and very soon we'll be able to use that as well. It is also a matter of pride that in our founding years, we have given enough impetus to sports facilities and activities, and lots of students who are going to represent the country or who have fought at the national level are also joining us for their higher studies here. We have 2 well-furnished auditoriums to host major events, and 2 more are being built, which are in addition to spaces like this, which we can use for any purpose. These are in addition to the overall facilities which we have for food courts, amphitheater, rangmanch, students activity center, and so on. Friends, MUJ is proud to be having a very good quality of faculty, staff, and students. We continuously build their capabilities and develop and enhance their potential for our stakeholders. Our education system is properly supported in terms of human resources, physical resources, financial resources, interdisciplinarity, innovation, etc., which are the building blocks of any good institution. You will be able to see all of them here and use them. It is also known, friends, a message for the young ones. This is not necessarily for the parents. It is known that many of you might have worked hard during the last couple of years trying to appear in several competitions like JEE. Maybe some of you could not make it to some of the desired institutions like IITs and NITs. There is no secret that many of us aspire to do that. But believe me, you are in the same class of excellence as you are in the top 10 or 20% of the country's total student population who was vying for engineering space. And therefore, you should not in any way feel inferior to any of these as on another day of examination of JEE for a similar kind of a test. Maybe you might have got a higher rank and they would have got a lower rank. That is the only difference. You believe you belong to the same league, and therefore you have to believe in yourself. The major attribute you require is self-motivation and will and zeal to succeed, and I'm sure you'll all be understanding this fact very clearly, that self-belief is the one which will take you farther. It can lead you to successes bigger than what you might have generally dreamt of. Then we can assure you that you are in safe hands of Manipal, where we will help and empower you to achieve all that what you are dreaming. I'd also like to advise and convey to you that do not feel challenged with anything while you are with us. We are student-centric and we try to help you and guide you to the extent possible, but please remember that it will have to be within the framework of our rules. Bending rules, accommodating rules would not be our forte. So please understand that clearly. And this morning, you are going to be exposed to some of the core rules, frameworks, expectations, do's and don'ts by the team here. We support multidimensional approaches such as short-term training programs, induction and orientation programs, which we are doing now, national and international conferences, workshop and training programs, research interactions, internal research seeding and funding, undertaking innovative projects, offering summer internship to our students and others, developing partnerships with industries and institutions, and arranging lectures for distinguished experts, supporting entrepreneurship, etc. There are a whole lot of things which everyone has to know today, and we are doing all that. In case we are not doing something, it can be brought to our notice and we'll be ready to take up that very, very easily. We have already incubated in this short span, only 2 to 3 batches graduating. We have already incubated 9 companies under the Manipal University Technology Business Incubation Program here, and are also driving the National Skills Development Corporation related program for skilling and certification. For success in all our endeavors, we impart wholesome knowledge to our students with intent to help their communities and self and continuous learning. In addition, these students are allowed to host and also to participate in extracurricular and co-curricular activities to enhance their communication and management skills as well as their self-confidence and motivation. We also offer them electives, skill and appreciation courses outside their regular class hours in several specializations leading to certifications which can lead to a better value for their professional position. I strongly urge and recommend to all our students to take advantage of these offerings as well as participate in a desired portfolio of activities of their interest. However, I just want, anyone cannot do everything. You should draw your limit, understand where your core interests and ideas lie, and join those groups. Don't try to do everything, because when you become jack of all, possibly you are not helping yourself. You should be, while you should learn and have a good bandwidth of learning, jack of all is fine, but there should be master of one at least is something what is very, very desirable. Almost all friends, we idolize many individuals for their leadership, sacrifice, or maybe unrelenting efforts in any direction. My dear young friends, like them, we should also build ourselves by facing challenges. You cannot be escaping challenges, be it a rainy day here, be it a day where you are not liking the food, be it a day where a teacher has not been kind because they come to the lake, all these will come. But these are integral parts of our life. And remember, I emphasize that there is no signal without noise, and of course there is no success without failures. So they will go hand in hand. Be prepared to face good and bad, right and wrong, black and white, whatever way may be, together as it comes to you. However, strive that you always try to go on the positive side or the right side or the white side, whatever you call it. So finally, with these words, I once again extend a very hearty welcome to all of you, with the hope that each one of you will give your best to fulfill your dreams, bring laurels and glory to yourself, as well as to our university and to our country, very importantly. So friends, wishing all you all a very, very happy, exciting and a productive journey ahead at MUJ. May God bless you all. Jai Hind, Namaskar.
Thank you, sir. I now call upon Registrar MUJ, Professor Vanna Suhar, to tell you about our university. Please, sir.
Good morning, students, dear parents, guardians, my senior colleagues, my other colleagues, the staff members, faculty members, and all support staff who is actually supporting us to organize this particular event and also to introduce you to the entire management of Manipal University Jaipur. As also I would like to take you through a little brief introduction about the group. So about Manipal University Jaipur, you already know, you must have read about it, that this university was established in 2011 by the State Act, and after that the university was established, and then this university is also recently recognized by UGC. Now our founders, you know that he is Dr. T.M. Pai, Padam Shri Awardee. He is the architect of modern Manipal, pioneered public-private partnership. Way back, they started in 1953 in Manipal, Manipal. And then they established the first professional education institute in non-government, which was non-government, non-missionary and self-financing sector. Dr. K. Ramanarayan is the chairperson, whom you can call it as the chancellor of Manipal University Jaipur. Dr. Ramdas Pai, he is emeritus chairman, chairperson, and also the board, earlier board member. Dr. Ranjan Pai, he is the chairman Manipal Education and Medical Group. He is also the board member of the group. Now, Manipal Education and Medical Group, they are specialized in education sector, healthcare, research and services. Multi-country footprints are very well known to all of us. Employers intake is more than 23,000 now. Manipal Hospitals, this is the third largest healthcare network in India, and more than 15 hospitals now. Major hospitals are 15 and other hospitals are more than that. 8 companies established in the group, and 3 universities are there in India. One is in Manipal, Manipal, Sikkim Manipal University, and in Manipal University Jaipur, and we have 3 universities overseas. Manipal Group at the forefront since 1953 is here in front of you. Set up the first medical engineering campus in 53, then till 1986 kept on adding the campuses. In 1993, Manipal University, Manipal was given the Green University status. 1994, Pokhran Medical Campus had come. 95, SMU, through the SMU Act, a first private partnership was signed with Sikkim government, and then established thereafter Sikkim Manipal University Jaipur, Sikkim Manipal University Sikkim, and then Medica Manipal College was established. 2000, we set up campus in Dubai, then Manipal Global started some of the courses at the Manipal Academy of Global Education, then Antigua campus was acquired and established in medical campus, then thereafter Manipal University Jaipur was established, and then established Malaysia, Malaysia International University, and also Global Next, which is specialized in higher management courses. Focus, as you are aware, that is on these particular sectors. Then this is just a glimpse of how we are placed globally. Now about introduction of our president, I need not explain you more, because he has just welcomed you here today morning, and I have also given you a brief input about how Manipal University Jaipur is established, and how many courses we are offering is also must be known to you, but just to give you a brief introduction, we offer multidisciplinary programs in varied disciplines like engineering, architecture, planning, arts, commerce, design, management, journalism, mass communication law, and other sciences courses. Other than health, we offer anything and everything here. Our vision is known to you, that is also placed wherever you move across the campus. Our vision, mission and values are available. Please go through those vision and help us to reach our mission, and also follow the values which we generally try to invite you. Our organogram is here in front of you, that we have the chairperson, who is the chancellor, then we have the president, and then we have five faculty deans, and then followed by the other directors, head of departments, and various other offices in charges. That also will come, will be known to you soon once you get exposed to all the departments and all the offices in your future. Now, our faculties, five, we have more than now 32 teaching departments are there. Students in date, as on date, is 7,500 approximately, and this academic and hostel area is 122 acres of land. We also have around 30 acres of land which is just across, which we are using for various kind of uses for sports activities and otherwise also. We offer many programs, that is also known to you. In infrastructure, we will be crossing more than 4 million of constructed area soon. We already have sufficient built up area. We have 850 kilowatt solar power generation, which is highest in Rajasthan, and a dome which is a very well distinct from that is very visible, that is highest dome GRC made in Asia, I must say, and also you can say in Rajasthan as well. Hostel facilities are also, you must have come across. Our student achievements in brief. One of our students, you must have seen when you had come for the admission, in case you have come to the Jaipur campus, one of our students, Anshuman, he had designed a Milo, which is a Manipal information robot. And why I am giving you such information is that you also know that what type of activities are generally our students are doing. They are good in technical activities, they are also good in writing skills. This is the achievement by Ms. Parthi Dixit, who has been certified as the world, who has actually created a world record by maximum online certificate courses, and her book was highest sold in Amazon. Within 4 hours, all her books were sold. That is life the way it is. One of our students, MBA, he has received 59 trophies national level, and he had also organized various motor sports rally under the leadership of Professor Rajesh Solanki and the management faculty. A student's achievements in sports will be explained to you a little later by our sports in charge. Sarvesh Parekh and Nikita Kavar, they are internationally known figures. They are our students who are very well known in the field of archery. Our other achievements are here. They also participate in fine arts and other kind of activities, winning many awards. Like in law also, many moot courts competitions they participate and also keep on receiving many awards even outside the state. Student achievements again, top coder open, Nikhil Dixit, computer science engineering student, he also won this award in 2015 also, so twice he has won this award. Student achievement again, our team Bars of Manipal University Jaipur, Jatin Simbal, then many awards and recognitions are also given on the website. I'll just give you a glimpse of that. Best campus and best facilities, best in Rajasthan, best in Northeast, in education sector, in placement, and so on. Our entrepreneur cell activities are many. We have 19 students who have village, 9 companies are registered. We also encourage the students to take on some global project by them in the final year of their BTech. Whether they succeed or they fail doesn't matter, but they are allowed to work on that project. More highlights, more about this particular kind of activities will be known to you later, maybe today or by your head of departments will be informing you. These are eminent alumni which you can go through in case you visit the our alumni site. Like Sandeep TTS is working with SAP Labs, and then the Indian Brain Building. We have Amangar, Rishabh Jain, he has his own company. Aksha Saraswat, he's in Amazon. Pallavi, she's studying in Boston University. Then Aditi, then Rumal, and so on. Many students are also joining NGOs. These are our star alumni, which we can say about the group. These are the glimpses of various kind of events which are, we have the Speak My Way chapter. This is Abhinav Das, who is the youngest Indian hacker to have his name in Google Security, right? IEEE student. Then international workshops are organized by our students. TEDx, that is Technical Entertainment Design, we have organized recently an event. These are the glimpses of some sports activities. More will be given to you later. These are some social activities as CSR activities which are carried out by our students only, not by us. We are just there for their support. But otherwise, these all activities are driven by students only. Jaipur International Film Festival, science and technology supported school children camps, Tech IT 8, Legal Aid Camp, Clean and Health Awareness Program, then teaching nearby school children, villages, some trips which they organize, some blood donation camps, drug addiction camps are organized by our students, road safety weeks organized. These are just few of them I have showcased here, health awareness programs. We also support NGO which is for specially abled children. Then they are also put in play and other activities. They also organize a certain kind of booster for our students to imbibe values in them. So these are some of the companies which had visited us. These are the sports activities. I am not going into detail of that because now not many sessions, not many my seniors will be coming and talking to you about it. Now let me introduce my student council to you, which is actually very important. May I now request Priyam, the president of student council, to come in front of the students. Friends, this is Priyam, our council president. He is the president of student council for year 17-18. Then we have Suresh, general secretary. Sayam, our sports secretary. Mayan, technical secretary. Mandi, cultural secretary. Rajbhushan, the treasurer. Now we also have 5 faculty representatives. They are not here today. Nikita Jaiswal, she is the faculty representative in the council from the Faculty of Engineering. Nikhil Bang from Faculty of Design. She is also a member of the council. Nikhil Sharma from Faculty of Science is there as the member of student council. Yashwan from Faculty of Management and Commerce, and Shreya from Faculty of Arts and Law. So this is our council. Now this council will play a very important role in your day-to-day activities, in your they will be helping you out, and they will also assure one campus which is and entry, which is ragging free, which they have promised that it will be a totally no drugs will be available on the campus, and no students will not be get influenced by drugs, and it will be a no smoking area altogether. Now, may I request the student council to take the oath that they will be making this campus as totally, totally no ragging area, no ragging institute for the students. So just say that you promise that there will be no ragging on the campus, Priyam. So shall I assure? Yeah. So just raise your hands that you assure. They assure that there will be no ragging, but you are also requested, advised to give due respect to your council and listen to their positive kind of feedback or positive support which is given to you. Priyam, you also now assure that you will also totally eradicate the drugs from the campus. Just give the same kind of assurance, because parents are looking forward for such kind of assurance from your side, and the same kind of support is required from the students who have now in front of us. So my students who are now today in front of us, among us first year, you also need to give the promise. Please raise your hands that you will not be getting influenced by drugs. Raise your hands, friends. Say no to drugs. Say no, at least no drugs, no smoke, and total values you will follow. You will respect your parents, you will also respect your seniors if they are giving you some positive kind of feedback, and you will also follow the values which are actually, we say, that Manipal University values. And you also promise that you will help us out to reaching a mission and vision which we are sure that we can reach very soon, in case you people are there in our support. Now, dear students, before I conclude, my council is also here. I want to say that most birds, that is Dr. Kalam's wording actually, most birds take shelter during the rains, but it is only the eagle that flies above the clouds. Manipal University Jaipur is the kind of institute that provides you to think differently and create an attitude to be like an eagle in life. Friends, an academic institution is not about rote learning, but also imbibing values that will let you create your own path and reach heights that an eagle reaches. My best wishes to you, and be assured that Manipal University Jaipur is a committed performer, and for that we also need a commitment from your side that you will also help us out in your day-to-day working, your day-to-day learning. Don't forget that your parents, for your one day which you are spending here with us, are spending more than 1400 rupees in case you are staying in the hostel. Remember that before you sleep, whether you have worked that much which your parents have given you financially, 1400 more than that probably, 1400 rupees daily they are spending on you if you are staying in the hostel, and it will less if you are a day scholar. So at least ensure that the financial the liabilities which or financial support which is given by the parents, you need to take care of that, and you also need to take care of the values, and you also need to take care of the sentiments of your parents as well as with us. Thank you so much. My best wishes to you, and I assure my dear parents and the guardians that we are there any point of time. If you want to reach us, you are welcome. You can approach any of us any point of time. Thank you so much. Thanks, once.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enlightening words. I now request Professor and MUJ, Professor N.N. Sharma, to brief you about our academic system at MUJ. Yes.
Honorable President, Professor Uday, our chief guest, my dear colleagues, dear parents, and dear students, very warm welcome to Manipal University Jaipur. And let me tell you that I was discussing, the campus has become vibrant again today. After this summer, is the vibrancy because of your presence. And moreover, we have become again young. Every year we become young because we interact and join with young fraternity, you people. So, once again, warm welcome. I'll start with one instance which has happened yesterday to mention why I'm going to talk about academics at MUJ and what we are expecting you from you and what ultimately is the implicit expectation. There will be some explicitly told things, but implicitly also there is something. So at the end I will show something. But before that I start, I must share an instance with you. Yesterday I met my friend who is among you, among the parents. We went to our college 32 years back, almost at the same time, 32 years back. And we relived that moment. He has come with his son to get him admitted here. We relived that moment and were discussing how we went there to our college. And we were discussing how after 32 years scenario had changed. So we went alone. We went with the hold on, with our trunks, with our suitcases, with imaginations what is going to happen in the future. You people are more clear for your future vision, what you want to do. You people are more supportive technologically. You have same kind of resources with you, what a teacher today have. In our time, teacher used to keep the books inside his locker. We didn't knew from which book what is going to be taught. Things are changing very fast. Technology is reaching all of you. How much the old things were relevant are relevant today? I mean, it is being debated at all forums. Manipal University Jaipur is trying to imbibe best practices. And those practices which we keep adding them time and again will be told where we are. We are open to suggestions. So parents, students, whatsoever you feel at your tenure at Manipal Jaipur, please do come, do walk in all the officials, all the administrators, tell them that this may be a good idea. We are open to all these inputs. So again, yesterday when we were discussing academics has also changed. So those changes is what I am going to show you during my presentation. So my professor of mechanical engineering, please remember me as a professor of mechanical engineering, not as co-president or dean faculty engineer. I work in microelectromechanical systems and nanotechnology, and I teach vibrations. So some of the contents which you may come across this presentation is introduction, then academic processes, question paper moderation, rate calculation moderation. How do we do it today? What we were doing earlier was a granular approach. Today the things are changing. Some of these things we are already acquainted with. So I'll be just naming them, but remember these things are important as well as to parents as well as to you. So promotion to higher years, academic management system, ERP, etc., etc. Before I start, let us have a look at the wagon wheel. And the outers of this wagon wheel, we keep decorating, we keep customizing, we keep designing. In inside core of this wagon wheel, this structure is currently core. I mean, that's not changing. So we have 5 faculties, and in each faculty there are schools, and each schools there are departments. And In each department, there are different programs. So we run different programs at graduate, postgraduate, and also the PhD program. There are around 30 departments currently, and one or two gets added, or depending on the relevancy, it may not be there. So they keep changing outer part of the week. So I'm using things like that. Among the academic processes, some of the things that you will be coming across with is choice-based credit system. So now it is not marks-based system, all of you know that. I mean, you have been experiencing that in your plus two level also. Here also there will be a credit-based system. You will be given a credit and grading, not the absolute marking. Absolute marks will be there, but ultimately it will be converted into a grade. And the change which you will figure out from your plus two to this is that it's a relative grading. So it's a population, and there's a scheme of Gaussian way of making the grades. So relative grading is there. More of it can be understood by, then controller of examination will be telling you about more about this. So it's a relative grading, please understand. And it's a credit-based system. You will be doing around 25 credits each semester. You will require minimum number of course, minimum number of credits. That is in engineering, for an example, it is 175 credits you have to do to get your degree. And second thing that you should remember is a continuous evaluation system. I'm repeating, continuous evaluation system. It's not one exam at the end that matters. So there is a weightage. Continuous evaluation has a weightage. Don't miss those exams. Don't miss those components. Everything is important. Of course, in teaching, learning, everything is important. But for your academic progress also, this is important. We do have provision for makeup exam and summer term, but these are specialized. I mean, I'll be expressing summer term slightly later. And as I said, that there will be a grade point average in CGPA where you will be indexed on your performances. It is not the absolute marking. So CGPA, of course, we have seen the CGPA in plus two level also. And there is a policy of promotion to higher semesters that I'll be explaining. That is more important for you people, dear students. It's very, very important to note this down, that there is a, if you want to go to higher semester, you have to do certain minimum qualifications. The examination process, and there is an academic calendar. Hope all of you have got the academic calendar. So as I said, that it's a grade-based system. We have divided into A plus A, B, C, D, E grades, and correspondingly those are the grade points 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. We have a fail grade and a detained grade. Fail is that you have, A, B, C, D is understandable that you fall in a particular group, but fail and detain are two different things. The detained grade, we detain those by the requirements of regulatory bodies. 75% of attendance is necessary. So will you be going for 75% attendance? I will expect 100% attendance. So to comply with 75% attendance, minimum, more the better. It is your credits, courses carry a certain number of credits. Student completes a semester when all the credits of that semester are earned. At 75%, of course, I am looking forward for 100%. The evaluation process is also weighted, as I said, that there will be midterm exams, there will be two sessionals, there will be a weightage of it. This weightage is only as an example. 60% is the weightage, 40% is for end term exam. The comprehensive exam is 40%, but this may vary from program to program, faculty to faculty. This will be told at the first day of your class, or within 1 week of your class, you will get a handout where everything will be explicitly explained, written on that. So these will be the lectures 1, 2, 3, 4, what are they going to teach you, and what are you supposed to carry along with it, and how much weightage each and everything is having, how many exams, which is assignments will be there in that. This will be told at the very beginning of the class. I hope all of you know that classes start from tomorrow. You have been given the timetable. Have you been given a timetable? Timetable, it will be displayed. It is uploaded on the website. Please see that classes start from tomorrow morning. It is uploaded on the website. It will be displayed at certain notice boards also. If you are finding any difficulty, you can approach us. You can approach Professor Rajesh Mathu and Dr. Ajay Kumar. Everyone will be helping you out in this. So don't get panicky if you have not got it. But website is already uploaded. When I interacted with few students, they said that yes sir, we know where what is the timetable tomorrow. So that's why I said that probably you have got the timetable. Be aware. And so tomorrow morning classes start. There will be mostly two sessional tests. There will be a lot of assignments and a lot of quizzes. We want your involvement. You learn. We progress. And in end semester plus end semester marks, there will be relative grading and 10 point grading, right? So, once the grade is given by the instructor, there is a grade moderation committee. It's a very open and transparent kind of system where you will be shown each time your answer books. If you have a question, you can actually justify yourself. But be sure. So, having that kind of transparency we keep, that you will be shown all the answer books, midterm, interim, etc. So makeup exam and summatum exam is something like, makeup exams are for fail or I grade. I grade is incomplete grade because of some genuine reason you have asked for a makeup hour. You fall sick on the end that particular day, or there are some other genuine reasons. We do provide, we have the provision of I grades, which can get converted into a regular letter grade by actually I. So conducted along with the summer term exams. For the first year, for you people, there will be a summer term exam where if some of you have not been able to clear the exam, you can actually appear in summer term. We float special courses, but the minimum number of students to float a course is 5. So, for the grading there, in summer term exam, grade boundaries remain same. Student appearing in makeup summer term exams are awarded one grade lower than the achieved grade. In case their grade is E, that is retained. Summer term is for 6 weeks, is available for first year professional programs. These are the points which you should note. You should not expect in the higher semester that you will be given a summer term. Branch change is allowed. Very few branches are become vacant, so there is a lateral movement. You can take it very, but it is very, very competitive. A slight amount of lateral movement can be there after first year, depending on your performance. Few seats, and those are very few in numbers and very competitive. CGPA calculation, most of you know, but you see that there is a formula, so you can see that there are CI, GI plus summation. Formula probably is known. As an example, I can show you. So, for example, in engineering mathematics, the credit is 4 and you got a grade A. A belongs to 9, so you earn 36 points. You summate this total and summate the total credits. So, last column divided by the first column gives you your CGPA. And you keep accumulating it over there. CGPA is cumulative, GPA means the grade point that particular semester. So likewise CGPA, and so you calculate your CGPA. Promotions to higher years is very important. Two things, don't look at this particular slide, it gives you an informative, but you can note down that to go to third year, all the courses of first year should be clear. Even if there is one unit course left out, you may not be promoted to third year. Similar happens with the fourth year. So for fourth year, you should have all the courses up to second year cleared. Not a single unit should be left out. So, of course, I understand that you are all good students who have come with me. It is becoming better and better. MUG is becoming approached by a better and better student. You will be doing very, very good. But our experience says that let us tell it to you in the beginning. We should strive to become what we want to do. We want to become the leaders in our future. Let us do very good from the beginning. For example, to go to the second semester you should have earned 30 credits in engineering. Then similarly, there will be other programs also, they require requirements. 30 credits. that to go to second, you should have earned 75, and likewise, so there are minimum credits that you should earn before you jump on to the next year, next semester. So these you should be clear in your mind. There is a maximum duration of completion of degree also, which has recently been changed by the UGC, AICTE regulatory bodies. So there is a maximum duration. 4 is the normal duration. I assume, I think it is 1.5 times 6 years, I think currently is the maximum number of years that in an engineering degree you can take. So these things kept in mind. There is a registration of each and every student on the very first day of every semester. So you should be very careful that you do register. And to do register, two criteria: one, you should have earned the credits that is required to register in a particular semester. Second is that, of course, that is the one financial part, so that is there. If a student fails in any course, he may re-register to you. Not only fail, somebody can also re-register in a course for improvement of the degree. That is also provided. So the flexibility is there in our system, where we accommodate such type of people who wants to improve their CGPA or etc. There is an examination process. Some notices will be coming to you. Who will be sending the notices? These things will be available. It is already available on our website. Please go to our academic regulations, which are available on the website, and the examination process also. Again, I am repeating, there will be continuous violation, many quizzes, many assignments, 2 midterm tests, and an end term exam. Now, this is what you are supposed to do within quotes, or this is what is explicit. What is implicit is you should learn. What is implicit is you should create your own space. What is implicit is you should be innovative. You should be leaders. I take this opportunity to tell you that we have very good students. They are doing a number of projects. Some of them were flashed here. Some of them will be flashed to you in due time. I am going to give you one example. There are such 20 incubations already happening. I think all of you have heard of Jaipur Food. Jaipur Food, most of you must have heard. And soon you will be hearing about Jaipur Hand. So it's a controlled hand. Hand has a lot of functionalities, many hands have come. The challenge was given to us by Jaipur Food people, Bhagwan Mahadev Viklang Sanstans. That is the one which is taking up the lead now. And our students not only created that, they have actually floated a company which is now having field trials and orders. There are some 20 such companies which have been started up by the time I reach my chair and the other person comes. This is a 2-minute video, it's over. Manalisal is in the third year, fourth year, right? We have done this. We see that this is the lowest prosthetic hand which we are developing. All the best, most welcome. You have to do these kind of things. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
introduce you to the different student activities, I invite Head BTech First Year and Chief Coordinator Student Activities, Professor Rajesh Mathur, to address you.
A very good morning and warm welcome to the Manipal campus. Chief Guest Professor Uday Kumar, Director MNIT Jaipur, Honorable President Professor Sandeep Sancheti, Group President Professor N.N. Sharma, Registrar Professor Vanda Suhak, Director Admission Professor Richa Arora, Dean Research and Innovation Professor B.K. Sharma, Dean Faculty of Arts and Law Professor Mridu Srivastava, Professor Avdesh Kumar, my senior colleagues, faculty members, students and respected parents and guardians. It is my proud privilege to welcome you all on behalf of Manipal University Jaipur and on my own behalf to the orientation program organized for the new batch of BTech students. It is an honor for me today to express gratitude to our Honorable President for his words of wisdom and advice, as well as expressions of encouragement to our newly admitted students. Manipal University Jaipur has marked its footprints in technical education in a very short span of less than 6 years and steadily progressing towards making Manipal University as a truly valuable learning center. All this has become possible because of the encouragement and cooperation that we have received from each one of my colleagues and students. Our progress would not have been possible but for their dedicated and sincere work. I look forward to receiving their continuing participation and support in the efforts to build Manipal University Jaipur a truly learning center. Our students have made us proud on various national and international platforms, and we expect that newly admitted students to imbibe the same culture. Our Board of Governors has ably guided us in our quest for excellence and has been bedrock of support and encouragement to us. We will continue to look forward to their inspired guidance. Manipal University Jaipur provides a unique environment for the holistic growth of students with various extracurricular activities organized throughout the year. Many activities are available to the students for sports, cultural and technical events. There are a number of student clubs which keep on organizing events regularly throughout the year. To name a few, the music club, the literature and dramatic clubs facilitate students to show their talents in cultural arena under the able guidance of faculty members. I now share with you some of the important informations meant for students and parents. These are all about the information which you will require from tomorrow onwards while you are starting attending your classes from 9 to 5. The section-wise list has been displayed on two notice boards so far, one in academic block 1 and another in the food court of hostel where you are having your lunch, dinners and breakfast. We have also displayed the timetable on all these notice boards. We have displayed teacher guardians list who will be taking care of you in case of any help you expect from our organization, maybe academic or maybe your personal. We are providing you laptops over which you will be connected with the faculty and officials through emails. All the notices they will be provided on through emails. And to inform you that when you want to leave the campus for any purpose, without outwash, you are not allowed to go outside the campus, because we need to be very sure that you are going out without permission and you are going to a place where you are safe and secure. Your security is our top priority. As far as your academics are concerned, we have a very rich library full of books, not only in print form but also in form of e-books, lots of literature, lot of websites which are meant for academic purposes, they are available to you. And through Wi-Fi campus, all these things are available to you round the clock. We have another feature in our university that the students are provided with the concept learned by doing. And for that, we have not many projects for the students which are conducted in thinking lab, where they can propose a project and under the able guidance of teacher mentor, they can perform those experiments and learn by doing those practicals. Now, one of the most important part about your academics is open book examination. In most of the subjects, you will be having open book examination, but this doesn't mean that you know the study. You have to prepare yourself well before you appear in any class test or midterm exams or end-term exams. You are supposed to study well, and these books are just as a support. We don't want you to memorize each and everything. Whatever is essential, you have to memorize them, and rest all you will have to look for through your open book practices. Another important thing is 75% attendance is mandatory, and while participating in different activities which are a continuous process, activities which are conducted throughout your academic session, you can participate them, but with the precaution that you are not supposed to cross the limits of 25%. All your absence will be counted in that, and you have to maintain 75% attendance during your academic year. Apart from this, there are various activities which are essential for your overall growth and competence. You are given the chance through various annual activities like cultural program known as Honoris, the sports program, sports event that is known as Abhivartan, and the technical event which is also annual, this is known as Tech IT. Now, apart from these activities, we have a number of clubs which gives you chance to work in harmony with your seniors, your teachers, your mentors, and you keep on adding activities, keep on adding to your knowledge and come out with some flying colors. The student chapters of various institutions are available for, say, for example, Institution of Engineers, India. You have student chapter in all the branches, almost in all the branches. You have other clubs for automobile engineering, for mechanical engineers. There are a number of clubs. And all those activities, they are like extension lectures, the presentations by experts from outside, from the industries, they come over here and give you presentation just to add to your knowledge. Now, along with this, one of the important part that you will be encountering is the student council. The student council members, you have been introduced by Honorable Registrar, and they are the true representatives. We consider all your applications through them. Applications means whatever your requirements which you want to expect from us, you can forward them to them, and we will take care of each and everything. So these are some of the important aspects which I would like to share with you, and please follow all those guidelines so that you are not in trouble. All these things earlier for the parents that you have to continuously monitor the evaluation process, the attendance of your part through the various passwords and various IDs are provided to you, sitting in the 4 walls of your residences, far, far away from this campus. You can watch the progress of your student, your ward, very well, and you can contact us if you find any difficulty at any moment. So with these words, I conclude, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.
I would now call upon Dean Faculty Affairs and Provost Professor Avdesh Kumar to tell you about the various scholarship schemes running in our university. Please, sir.
Good morning. Very good. The chief guest of the day, Professor Avdesh Kumar. The President and MPA, Professor Sancheti, my colleagues, parents and dear students. During the last one and a half hour, we have lot of information about the university, and I'm sure. And this is what you have to follow. But now I'm going to talk to you something different. I think ever since the admission process started for you, there was the demand that you have to deposit some money in the university to take up the course. I'll be talking about you since you are very meritorious students. I'll be talking to you that how to have the money from the university, and then how to have the merit also. So this will be my topic, and I hope that this will be of interest to all of you. May I know that how many students raise your hands who are interested in getting the scholarship from the university? Anybody? Oh good, you are a good number. There are opportunities. Many opportunities are there, and very brief, I will just summarize it. The information is available on the website. You'll get a notice within a month's time. There is a process, you apply for that one and take advantage of it. I won't take much of time, very briefly I'll touch upon on that too, so that you may just have a glimpse of it, that how the things are there. In the Manipal University Jaipur, as we call it, the M2J, there are 12 categories of scholarship for the meritorious students. And apart from that, there are 4 more scholarships under our patron and our chairperson, Dr. Ram Das Pai and Mrs. Basant Pai, and that is by way of endowment fund. Now these are the 12 categories of scholarship. Various are there. These are there for the PG, UG, engineering and non-engineering. For example, they have a Pai engineering scholarship, they have a Pai merit scholarship and so on. There are certain tuition fee waiver scheme. You can take the advantage of a scholarship by way of seat reservations. You can get the merit scholarship and so on and so forth. As far as the financial assistance under the endowment fund is concerned, there are 4 schemes. First of all is the entrepreneurship grant. I think it's very, very important because all of you are enterprising. This is one of the assets for which you have come over here, everybody. Let's explore it. Then, for you it could be, for the B.Tech student, it's a very, very important aspect of it. The other scholarships are for PhD, M.Tech and so on. So, now, in all the scholarship schemes are there for the UG student, PG student and the research scholar in the domain of engineering and in non-engineering. I just focus a bit about you, means the B.Tech program. For you, the program is first of all TMFI Engineering Scholarship. This scholarship is available to a student in each stream of engineering. and the eligibility is that you should be within 3000 rank in MU engineering entrance examination. The second is the DMFI engineering scholarship, and now these are some of the attributes. You can have up to 5 lakhs or 100% fee waiver. You can have something between 5 lakh and 7.5 lakh. You can have from 7.5 lakh and 10 lakh. You will get from 10 to 12.5 lakh and so on, depending upon your merit in the examination. Now, scholarship in engineering category would be for 90%. Criteria for the marks and qualifying examination, the fee waiver would be 100%. In case you are getting 80% marks, then your fee waiver would be 50%. And in case you are there within 75%, your fee waiver will be 25%. You will get all the details, these are already available on the website. I am just touching upon, to give you a basic idea about that one. For the lateral entry transfer cases, of course, it will not be applicable for you, but the students who are coming to the second year, now this scheme is already there for them. Then there is a Rajasthan Merit Scholarship, and this scholarship is given in each stream and one in each non-engineering stream. So the student should be from the Rajasthan domicile and he should have passed 10 and 10 plus 2. Then there is a big incentive. You can attend to various seminars and conferences. So we encourage you that you can devote your time. In fact, now it's a very important aspect by which you can have enhancement in your knowledge. Now for a sports person, there are certain schemes by which they can take the advantage by way of admission as well as by some incentive through fee waiver. Now there are certain tuition fee concessions for the MGA graduates who are taking admission in the PG courses. When you complete your BTEC, you can take advantage of it, and I'm sure that it would give a lot of values to you. Now, coming to the scheme under Dr. Ramdas Pai and Mrs. Basanti Pai and some scheme. So entrepreneurship grant is there. So you can have entrepreneurship grant to students up to the 6 projects, and you will get it up to a sum of rupees 1 lakh per project for your innovation work. Likewise, scholarship for the international student is there. Now these are 9 in number, and each student will get a financial assistance up to a limit of 1 lakh per student. So these are some of the schemes I touch upon. I know that already time is running very, very fast. I have just given you a glimpse of it. You can have information through our website and make use of it. It's only for you. Make use of it. So it will give you not only financial assistance, but also will give you a name. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now invite Dean Faculty of Management and Commerce, Professor Nilanjan Chattopadhyay, to tell you about the training and placement happenings at MUJ. Please, sir.
Very good afternoon. Not hear you. Good afternoon. That's a little better. Not full marks. You get half marks. So now that Professor Ardesh Kumar has told you about how to get money, let's talk about how to utilize that money and how to earn more. Before I go ahead, let me assure you that this university, as well as the placement cell, we do our best to give you something, but you have to do the rest. How? Let's take a very, very simple example. For example, you are having a car and you want to drive, but to drive, you need first a destination. You can go for a joyride, but a joyride lasts for a very short time. To make the drive longer and smoother and better, you need to have a destination. Who will set that destination? You. Compare that to your BTEC life. You need to have a target for yourself. This is where I want to go after 4 years when I pass out of BTEC. That's your destination. Set it today. Set it right now. And then to reach that destination with your vehicle, you need a road. Believe me, this university and the placement team, we will provide you the road. But that's about all. We will give you the road, we will give you the best of road. We are well equipped. We have the best placement team in this state, if not in the country. We have, in this last less than 6 years, we have moved orbit. But to be on that road, to be in your vehicle, to drive to your destination, you need fuel, right? Without fuel, your car will not move. That fuel for you will be your studies. Believe me, no company will let you in unless you are strong in your academics. If you feel you have done enough outside the classroom, that's very good. But you need to do equally good in your classroom. So those studies that you make, those technical knowledge that you gain, that's your fuel. But is the fuel enough? Just if you get fuel in your car and you keep moving on a beautiful road to your destination, will you be happy? Answer is no. I can see a number of heads nodding, no, no, no. You need AC, you need comfort, you need a good car, you need other things. Now what are those other things for you here? You will have n number of competitions, starting from floated by companies, to floated by organizations, to floated by institutions. Participate in as many number of competitions as you can. Winning is important, but winning is not very important. But how many competitions you have participated, how many projects you have done, these all add on to your resume, and that way it all adds on to the brand of the university. So to add AC and comfort to your car, as you add on, in your BTEC life, you add on those competitions. Now, is that enough? Again, no. If the destination is long enough, or the route is long enough, you need food, coffee, etc., etc. Now, what are those etc.s? Here, you can earn a lot of certificates. Certificates in form of maybe extracurricular or co-curricular. What do I mean? If it's extracurricular, you learn something that is new, that you have never done before. And you learn it so well that you master it and get it certified. Each certificate adds a line to your resume. You will obviously learn a number of technical things in your BTEC program. For almost every technical knowledge, there is a certifying body. There is an international certifying body for that. Go for those certificates. And when you come to interview, when you come for your jobs after 4 years, believe me, all of these, your certificates, your BTEC results, more than results, the knowledge that you have acquired, the projects that you have done, the competitions that you have won, all of these will carry huge amount of weightage. And we are there to assure you the best possible road on earth to make your journey smooth. We are there in the placement office. There is a small, nice team. We are all ready to help you. If you have any questions at any point of time in your career, do come back to us. Thank you and wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir. Apart from academics, research also plays an important role to shape your career ahead. To tell you about the research activities and opportunities at MLJ, I invite Dean Research and Innovation, Professor Vicky Sharma. Yes.
Respected Chief Guest, Professor Vijay Kumar, President MLJ, Dr. Sachiti, and my other colleagues, dear students and parents, media. Well, I stand here to motivate you for something which is very different here at Manipal, namely the research and innovation. The vision statement you have already seen because our president talked about it, the minister also talked about it. It will be displayed everywhere, you will see it. But my only request to you is contribute to enable us to achieve it. You are the drivers. You will be the one who are going to be carriers to take and use it forward. So decide about it and pick up something that you want to contribute to. One of the things which we have is the most preferred university for innovation and interdisciplinary learning. Foster academic, research and professional excellence in all domains. And we want to build you competent professionals with good human values. So remember those things, because those are our key points. Those are the points where we want to take you forward with. At Manipal Group, we are committed for research, for promotion of research. In fact, research is an essential component of all programs at MUJ. Just to give you an idea, that Manipal University, Manipal, our parent university, has been ranked as the first in the research category among non-government universities in India. The recent NIRF ranking, Manipal University, Manipal stands at 32 and we stand in the band 151 to 200. In 6 years span, to get at least recognized within 20% of the Indian university is not a small task. But we don't stop here. Our aim is to go backwards so that the next time you go from 100 to 150 and then 50 to 100 and so on. So you can very well realize that our road map is very clear. We want to progress strongly in this area. We have got a lot of major thrust areas in which people are working. Nanomaterials, nanotechnology, computer network, security, embedded systems, IoT, image processing, built environment, composite materials, environment and energy, communication technologies, fluid mechanics, fuzzy logic, material science and technology, semiconductor devices, tissue culture and medicinal plants. These are some of the major thrust areas that are available in this university. You will have faculty members who are working actively in these areas, and in fact there are many more. It's difficult to list all of them, but we call them major because there will be more than one faculty, and there will be some grants available also for the project to run. The MUJ has a very special provisions. We have separate budget for research and development. Just as was mentioned before, there is a fund called endowment from our promoters. There we encourage the students to prepare projects. We support from MUJ funds, or we encourage you to apply to other funding agencies like State DST and ICMR. In fact, last year, two of our students got support from ICMR on a project which was related to the life sciences. There are interdisciplinary areas. We have linked research in the interdisciplinary area, and there are a lot of university linkages. We have very strong linkages with the universities, which you can make use of. I will talk about them briefly. To the students, if you have some idea which you have developed and you want to present it to a conference or to a workshop or to a seminar, the university can give you up to 15,000 maximum. There is a grant for entrepreneurship projects up to 1 lakh maximum. university also provides space and mentoring if you have some idea which you want to develop. In today's world, getting good grades is not enough. As was mentioned by Professor Niranjan, you have to have something extra. If you want to stand differently, you have to do differently. You have to make your different achievements, and those achievements should be visible. In today's world, three things are visible. One, the research, the entrepreneurship, and the innovation. So these are the three words that you should remember, and you should get involved and do participate actively. Nine companies we have already mentored here, they are functional in MUJ. Biltmore Technologies, you have just seen the video. These are one of the incubation company we supported about 2 years back, and it's doing very well. Likewise, there are Martopolis, Innovative Solutions, Skills Foods, Ali Home, Socio, Edu, Curious, Vivaldi Care, Dot Foods, IBNOX. These seven are operational at MUJ, and there are other seven which are functioning from outside MUJ. So 16 of our students like you have crystallized their ideas and are getting supported from us, and they are doing very well. They are not job seekers, now they are job providers. So you may be wondering why at the first year level we are being introduced all these things. But number one, orientation program is only once. When you enter into the first year, we presume you should get a global, a wholesome view of the universities, like a cinema trailer, because a cinema trailer doesn't show the whole movie, but it does show the attractive parts, attractive features. So these are things which you should keep in mind, get in contact with your senior students, try to learn, talk to your faculties, and if you have something from day one, nobody stops you, you can certainly be involved in doing that. We have research projects today, 20 in number, and out of these, 18 are going on to have been completed with a grant of about 6 crores. There is every reason for you to explore your involvement into those projects. I don't guarantee you will get money, but what I can guarantee is you will get exposure, you will get training, and at some stage, you will also be able to contribute in the project. And that will go a long way in your career. There are a lot of labs where this research or advanced work is going on. I have listed them. It's not easy to read all and will not be easy for you to read as well. But you could certainly get in touch and find out which are the labs, are the facilities you can be involved. And don't hesitate to contact their in charges. I can read a few like NICOP, Bionet Research Lab, Material Science Research Lab, there's a supercomputer lab which has Param Shawar. There are Bosch Sensoric Lab, Bosch Skills Development Center, and so on. There's a Bioscience Research Lab, Environment Science and Geology Lab. A green fest house facility is coming up because we got a project from Medicinal Plant Research Board to group to develop and to culture the extreme machine plants. So these are the things, some of the very highlighting things. There is an information technology lab, automobile mechanical engineering lab, electronics and communication engineering lab, civil engineering lab, you know, everything. And one more thing. When we talk of interdisciplinary, please don't limit yourself to your domain of engineering. You can expand your base to any other discipline. And that will add a lot of value because today, what is respected most is the interdisciplinary capabilities. Nanotechnology came and soon it was adopted by the bio people. It became bio-nanotechnology. It is being employed by the IT people, it has become microelectronics or nanoelectronics. It is being employed by the mechanical engineers, it becomes nanorobots, nanosensors, and everything that you can think of, you can create through the interdisciplinary approaches. We have a lot of linkages with foreign universities, a lot of them. This is a list which is a huge list, in fact. This one of the particular clause in all these MOUs, in all these linkages, is that student and faculty exchange. So as a student, if you have some ideas, if you feel like you can explore those avenues and have opportunity to visit those labs, work there, attend some summer training programs or some courses, and NUJ will facilitate that. Likewise, we have a lot of national collaborations. We have collaboration with National Skill Development Center, Bhagwan Mahavir Viklang Sahayata, DST Rajasthan, CIPET, CGCRI, SMS Hospital, CD Pilani, CSIR, IIP, IPE Hyderabad, and CTAC, and so on. There's a whole list that are there. Likewise, there are industrial houses, industrial companies with which we have. There are secure meters, the hotel management people have collaboration with hotel cards, net metering, indirect rubber, Bosch Limited, United Phosphorus, and so on. So, it's up to you how you utilize your time. How much horizontal expansion you want to go on, vertical expansion you will be expected, because if you want to get good grades. But expand your base, and if the base is very wide, yes, you can think of building a tall building. It can withstand those tall structures. Best of luck. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. A hostel is a home away from home. Hostel life has a charm of its own. It's an experience that takes you out of your comfort zone and exposes you to several experiences that makes you strong to face the outside world. To tell you about the hostel life at MUJ, I request Chief Warden, Mr. Anil Kumar Singh, to address you all. Please.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for being with us. Your presence delighted me like anything. In fact, it's an honor for me to be here. I can't see the parents who are sitting on upstairs, but I think you can surely hear my voice. I'm standing here as caretaker of your parents, of your students. But what I can see, what a heavy session you have so far. Everyone is so relaxed. Are you with me? I can't hear you at all. Can I make a request to all of these students? Please stand up at your place. I just want to know what kind of energy level you have. Just keep, what, if you have anything in your hand, keep it down. I'll start counting 1 to 10 from here. And you need to jogging at your own place. And I want to show to the university that what kind of youth and energy we have. Can we start? I will not say anything, but I want to hear the loud voice. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great. Please sit down. Again, many of you are sitting in a relaxed mode. Just see, my friend. Keep your back straight. There's a fact of life, if you want to hear anything and if you want to concentrate, your back should always be straight. Sathiyo, main koi gyani nahi hoon, main koi scientist nahi hoon. Haan, gyan ka premi zarur hoon. Aur abhi tak kuch seekh raha hoon. और मेरा अपना ऐसा सोचना है कि apprehension से नहीं, observation से सीखा जाता है. और जीवन में जो कुछ सीखा है, मैंने अपने observation से ही सीखा है. जहां तक ज्ञान की बात है, देखिए, ज्ञान एक ऐसा investment है जिसका dividend आपको पूरे जीवन के अंत तक मिलता रहता है. I will definitely share some of the things of my own life with you, although the time is very short, just 10 minutes, but we'll try to complete. देखिए जीवन में कुछ ऐसी चीजें होती है जो अगर आप एक बार सीख लेते हैं तो आप जल्दी से नहीं भूलते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्विमिंग इज वन, साइकिलिंग इज वन. अगर आपने एक बार वो सीख लिया तो आप कभी नहीं भूलेंगे. मणिपाल यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर में भी जो आपकी शिक्षा होगी वो ऐसी होगी कि आप उसको जीवन भर नहीं भूलेंगे. ये जरूर निश्चित है कि there will be few moments where you will not be that comfortable related to your studies because you need to put hard work. लेकिन ये जो गंभीरता आप यहाँ पे अपने विषय में अपने सब्जेक्ट में डालेंगे that will give you big dividends और आपको ये नहीं पता कि कितना आपको उसका फायदा जीवन में मिलने वाला है. Because whenever you will chase knowledge, numbers will always follow automatically. Never run for money, money will come to you as a byproduct. Just keep listening to us. आप सब लोगों ने हॉस्टल का इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर तो देख लिया है and I'm sure I need not to go into details. I have request to all of you just look at the site and smile. What is it you are? Don't get distracted. Don't get distracted. आप लोग इतना सीरियस मत होइए. आप सब लोगों ने हॉस्टल देखे हैं. हॉस्टल के अंदर जो रूम्स हैं हमारे दे आर स्टेट ऑफ द आर्ट रूम्स एंड फैसिलिटीज ऑल्सो. As far as the infrastructure is concerned, we have a huge infrastructure and I'm sure you all have seen or you will be seeing now. Everything I'm sure by now you must have seen. I, being a chief warden, works with a team of wardens, caretakers, and we have our own company, Manipal Integrated Services, huge team of security persons. We all will always be there. There's a small emergency, but nothing to worry. You all need to listen to us. Because there is a medical emergency and we have 24/7 medical facilities here.
I'll request if there is a doctor in this hospital. Any parent who is a doctor, medical doctor, can you please help with the medical emergency?
Please go on the first floor, sir. Thank you. Dr. Abhishek, can you call the hostel and get the ambulance immediately? Nothing to worry, we have every facility available at the hospital. And it's by chance that I'm talking to you for a medical facility, that there is some medical exigency which is being attended. As far as food is concerned, one of the major criteria, but we have a number of outlets available in the hospital and we have an amazing mess where you get a delicious food. Gym, of course, you must have seen. Now, gentlemen, this is a slide where, you know, the color has slightly changed. Just look at this slide. There are certain hostel rules and regulations which we want each one of you to follow. Detail, we will not go into all these things. We will be telling you all these details in subsequent days. The only thing for the parents especially, there are so many students, they are coming from the nearby areas where the drive is just 6 hours, 8 hours or 10 hours. No student is allowed to go without taking a proper permission from the chief warden office. because you all are giving this big responsibility to us of your daughters and sons, and we have accepted this responsibility, but we need your support. Never ask your kids to go home without taking a obtaining a proper out pass. We will be having a biometric attendance system also. Each student has to, without fail, every day mark the attendance in the biometric system. You will agree with me that at some point of time your parents, kya aisa koi student hai jisko uske parents ne kabhi koi saza nahi diya ho? Aisa koi? Can anyone stand? Chahe choti ho, badi ho, lekin hum bhi kuch galat karte hain ghar mein to saza milti hai. So, dekhiye, we are also like your parents, we are like your guardians, but कुछ ऐसे रूल्स रेगुलेशन हैं कि अगर आप उनको तोड़ेंगे तो आपको उसका सजा मिलना एकदम निश्चित है. हालांकि मैं ये मान के चलता हूँ, पूरा कॉन्फिडेंस है मुझे कि ऐसा आप बिल्कुल नहीं करेंगे. आप यहाँ पे किसी नियम कायदे का उल्लंघन करने नहीं आए हैं. यू ऑल हैव कम हियर फॉर अ नोबल कॉज. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर, इफ यू आर डूइंग एनीथिंग रॉन्ग, यू विल बी गिवन पनिशमेंट एज पर योर whatever you are doing. So let's avoid those things, because our punishment system is very stringent. You will come to know in couple of weeks time that what this DOT system is. Again, I'm saying we don't want to punish you. Similarly, you also need to follow strictly on the guidelines. And we have been talking about the ragging part. My earlier people have talked about the ragging. You can be rest assured 100%. So far this campus is 100% zero ragging. There is no ragging at all. We have the teams, they are stationed, they are in place to take care of ragging and everything. As I said in the beginning, there is a limitation of time, but I would like to call upon few people which you might have seen, our own students. For last 2 days they have been wearing a particular kind of a t-shirt. Can the Mitra team come in forward? Okay. Along with these two council, we have a Mitra team. They are helping in last 2 days, all of you. Whenever you have any issue related to anything in the hostel side or in the university side, simply as you see this Mitra team, go to them, approach them. They will be helping you. And just come in the front. As you have already seen, some of these people are part of our council also. You can just see their logo, Mitra logo is there. Right? So this logo you need to just keep in mind. Priyam is also there. The entire council is part of Mitra team. Wherever you find any difficulty, how many of you have seen these people working in the hostel for last 2 days? Majority of you have seen. That's excellent.
Sorry for interruption. Just to inform you, there were some diabetic parents. The father felt uneasy. The mother requested for a doctor and the ambulance. Both of them have been moved to the medical center. No need to panic. Thank you.
So these are the team. We have such 50 people. Give a big round of applause for them, because you know what, they are only for you. Thank you so much, Mitra team. You can now go to your respective places. I'll just conclude in another 1 minute. देखिए, मणिपाल यूनिवर्सिटी में जितने भी लोग यहाँ पे हैं, हम सब आपकी सफलता के साक्षी बनना चाहते हैं. वी ऑल वॉन्ट टू विटनेस योर सक्सेस हियर इन मणिपाल यूनिवर्सिटी. आप अमीर हैं, गरीब हैं, इससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. विश्वविद्यालय में हर छात्र छात्रा के लिए इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी है. द ओनली थिंग यू नीड टू हैव कॉन्फिडेंस ऑन योर सेल्फ. As I said earlier also, you need to work for meaning, not for money. Money will automatically come to you as byproduct. If you have any queries regarding the hostel, You are free to come anytime in the hostel. We work for 24/7 and different layers are there, setup is there. So you will not have any problem. Still, in case if it is there, please come to us. थोड़ा सा मुस्कुरा वाला सब लोग इतना सीरियस बैठे हुए हैं डोंट बी सो सीरियस सच अ ब्यूटीफुल कैंपस अमेजिंग पीपल आई से ओनली वन थिंग इन द लास्ट कौन कहता है कि आसमान में छेद नहीं हो सकता कौन कहता है कि आसमान में छेद नहीं हो सकता एक पत्थर तो तबीयत से उछालो यारो विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट हैव अ नाइस स्टे Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. There's a famous saying, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. It means apart from studies, playing and exercise is also important to free your overtaxed mind. To tell you about the sports facilities available in our university, I call upon Dr. Reena Pune. Please, ma'am.
Good afternoon to all. Respected Chief Guest, Professor Uday Kumar, President Sir, Pro President, Registrar Ma'am, Deans, Director, HODs, teachers, parents, guardians, and students. I am Dr. Reena Punya, Associate Professor of Physical Education, is here to update you regarding the sports facilities. As we know that sports is friendship, sports is life, sports is health, sports is education, sports brings words together. MUJ always promotes sports, fitness and health. We have impressive infrastructure at MUJ to promote the sports and fitness. Someone rightly said, there is no glory in practice, but without practice, there is no glory. To level your practice, we have international standard outdoor and indoor sports facilities at MUJ. Outdoor sports facilities you can see in the slides. Cricket grounds. Basketball, we have four international standard synthetic courts. Kabaddi courts, separately for men and women. Football court, volleyball court, tennis. Well-developed tennis courts. This year we organized All India Inter-University Tennis and West Zone Inter-University Tennis Tournament. Our Indian rising star, Ms. Karman Kaur Thandi, Ms. Kuhana and Ms. Iti Mehta were participated in the tournament. Badminton courts, track and fields, indoor sports facilities. We have international standard 5 space court at MUJ hostel sites, chess and carrom, table tennis, well-equipped gym with sauna bath, jacuzzi, aerobics and yoga room. Intra-university sports calendar 2017-18. All inter-university tournament will be organized according to this calendar. Interested student can register on time and selected student on performance basis, they will be participated in All India Inter-University Tournament and National Tournaments. Course offers. Based on the popular demand of the society of the sports, we offer BBS program and along with two open elective courses. Sports policies. To promote the sports persons, we have a sports policy at the MUJ. 1% seats of total in engineering branch and 2% seats in non-engineering branch reserved for sports persons. Fee waiver. 30% fee waiver in tuition fee for state champions and national level participation in recognized tournament. 60% fee waiver in tuition fee is allowed to that candidate receive silver medal and bronze medal at national level recognized tournament. 80% fee waiver in tuition fee for gold medalist at national level tournaments. And 100% fee waiver for international level participation in recognized tournament. To continue this scholarship, you have to active actively participate in university sports. Glimpses of Abhivarta. Every year we organize annual sports fest, Abhivarta, national level annual sports fest, Abhivarta, third week of February. Glimpses of West Zone and All India Inter-University Tournament. Achievement of Motor Sports and Archery. Our MBA student Lakshmir Dabas won many championship trophy at national level in car rally motor sports, and he organized a very good car rally at first car rally at LVJ. And Mr. Sarvesh Parikh won 4 medals at All India Inter-University Archery Championship in compound event. Sports personalities visited at NUJ. Olympian Krishna Punya, Olympian Professor Maria Joseph from Spain, right now she is the Olympic Committee member, Scientific Olympic Committee member. Mr. South Africa, Dr. Noor Habib, Professor James Skinner, Ms. Siva Megan, Dronacharya Awardee, Devendra Kumar Rathod, Uma Patel, and Niharika Kaur. Glimpses of Health and Fitness Program. Every year we organize National Sports Day. That day we organize marathon for the students, International Yoga Day, and Rhythmic Dance and Aerobics organized by Monica Devna. Don't limit your challenges, challenge your limits. Our own student, Mr. Manish Pandey, blade runner, is the living example of this code. He won 2 medals for India in 2016. He lost his leg in 2011. Faculty, if you face any type of difficulty in related to sports, you can meet concerned faculty, myself, Dr. Reena Punya, Dr. Pradeep Singh Chahar, and Ms. Poonam. Finally, I would like to request you please visit our sports arena after the session. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Reena. In addition to what Dr. Reena Punya, our senior sports officer, has told, I'd like to add that MUJ is the only university in India which has organized 3 car rallies under the banner of Federation Motorsports Council of India. I now invite Advisor Library Professor N. D. Mathur to brief you on the library facilities available at MUJ.
Chief guest of the function, Uday Kumar, President of JP, Galaxy of Academia, students and parents. I extend a very hearty welcome to all the students and the parents. Library facility is a learning resource of every institution, and I would request all the parents to visit our library today so that you can see our learning resources. Albert Einstein has said that the only thing that you absolutely have to know is the location of the library. And this is the location of our library. The admin building is the left side. The library is situated, located. We have 3 libraries in MPJ campus. There is the central library in the admin building. Then there is a library for the law faculty in the building which is situated just in the left side of this board, and the design library which is the admin building at the first floor. Regarding library overview, it was made operational since inception, that was 2011, since the inception of the Manipal University Jaipur. It is catering to the information needs of the faculty, research, scholars, and students in engineering, architecture, design, management, humanities, social sciences, law, basic and applied sciences, hotel management, commerce, etc. It occupies a privileged place of pride among the students and academic community at MPG campus. There are separate libraries for School of Law and Faculty of Design. Regarding objectives of the library, it is to acquire, manage and disseminate information, to deliver timely, accurate and recent information to users, to provide information services and access to bibliographic and full text digital and printed resources, to support and facilitate the research, learning and teaching activities of the university, to inculcate an appropriate and congenial environment and facilities for learning. So regarding learning resources, our proposition was recently mentioning in his address about the prosthetic hand, which is the creation of Manipal. Now, where the secret of the prosthetic hand lies? Where the secret of this knowledge lies? The secret lies in the library, secret lies in our resources, secret lies in books, e-books, e-resources, repositories, print journals and magazines, and the newspapers. So make use of them. The books, it is for the information of the student that we issue 3 books and they can be issued to each student for 15 days at one point of time. So regarding e-books, this is the link given here. You can have access of the e-books with this link. The e-resources, we have various e-resources, IEEE, ASME, ASCE, Science Direct, Cabinet, EPSCU, EPWRF, Manupatra, Supreme Court cases online, Access India, Corporate Law, Advisor online, Air online, these are the e-resources available. There are packages of e-resources, IEEE, ASPP and POP Combo subscription package, is the web link given, and it can be used by students of electrical, electronics, computer science and IT. American Society of Mechanical Engineers, ASME, the web link is given here and the package is for use of the mechanical engineering students. American Society of Civil Engineers, ASCE, the web link is given here and civil engineering students can make use of it. McGraw-Hill Success Engineering, all engineering branches students can make use of it. Then Science Direct Engineering and Computer Engineering and other sciences. The engineering and computer sciences students can make use of it. DELNET ProQuest, all engineering branches students can make use of it. Similarly, DELNET, NEPTEL, DELNET membership, ProQuest, EBSU, LIFE, EBSU, Business Sources, EBSU, Hospitality and Tourism Company, EBSU, Art and Architecture. The concerned students can make use of these sites. Similarly, EBSU, Academic Search LIFE, EPWRF, India Time Series, Manupatra for law students, Supreme Court cases online for law students, Lexis India, Corporate Law Advisor online, Air online, these are for law students. Now, repositories and print journals and magazines, they cannot be issued for reading in the central library only. You can make use of them and you can read in the library. And there is library management software in our library is POA. For lending services. Recently, we are equipping library with radio frequency identification system, RFID, that is library automation system, which will be made functional from next month. Ventilated and air-cooled reading as well as good discussion rooms are there in the library. And additional reading area is provided during examination. Computers with high-speed internet and Wi-Fi connectivity are there. Web OPEC facility for online searching of library collection. Organization of book fair twice in a year, September and January are the months when we organize book fairs. Library familiarization workshop for new members that will be held in August. Then access to National Digital Library of India, the web link is given. The membership of DELNET and associate membership of Flipnet we have taken. You can make use of it. Regarding library membership, it is mandatory to have library membership for all the students. ID cards are issued to each student through the section coordinator. Based on ID card, Dr. Alka Pandey, who is a student librarian, the library grants the library membership. Library members may borrow 3 books for 15 days at one point of time by showing their ID cards at the circulation counter.
We have a collection of around 43,000 books in Central Library. Provision of 5 meters also there if there is delay in submission of the issued books. No library member is allowed to carry any item, personal books, bags or any other item inside the library except laptop, subject to adherence of prescribed operation policies. Please keep this in mind. There are library timings also. In general, the timings Monday to Saturday are 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. On Sunday, it is 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. During university exam, from Monday to Saturday, it is 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. And during summer and winter vacations, the timings are 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. But all Sundays, it is 9 to 5 p.m. 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. There is a library team, me as advisor, Dr. Renu Kumawat. Here, Dr. Renu Kumar, please. She is the co-advisor with me. And if you have any problem regarding traffic, you can either come to me or you can contact Dr. Renu Kumar. There are others also, which you will meet in the library premises. And there is the website also of library, you can go through that. Gandhiji's talisman regarding books is Pustako ka mulya ratno se bhi adhik hai. क्योंकि रत्न बाहरी चमक दिखाते हैं जबकि पुस्तकें अंतःकरण को उज्ज्वल करती हैं। फ्रेंड्स, सफदर हाशमी ने सेड कि पुस्तकें किताबें आपको चाहती हैं, किताबें आपके पास आना चाहती हैं। किताबों में साइंस का राज है, किताबों में रॉकेट का राज है, किताबों में साइंस की आवाज है, किताबों में कितना बड़ा संसार है, किताबों में कितना बड़ा संसार है और किताबों में ज्ञान का भंडार है। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एट एमयूजे योर सिक्योरिटी इज आवर टॉप प्रायोरिटी। टू ब्रीफ यू अबाउट द सिक्योरिटी एस्पेक्ट्स हियर एट एमयूजे, आई रिक्वेस्ट कर्नल रतन सिंह, चीफ सिक्योरिटी ऑफिसर, टू शेयर हिज व्यूज।
Honorable Chief Guest, visionaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to the Manipal University, and my security team especially welcomes you all. Generally, there is a feeling that security is a hindrance. Actually, in a normal flow, it is. But just to straighten away the system, the security just tries to correct you. Please don't take it as a hindrance, take it as an advice. There are certain points which I'll give out. They are just for your consumption. Try to adhere as much as you can. The more you adhere, the better it is. Firstly, there will be mock drills, which is a mandatory requirement as per the Government of India and UGC guidelines. We will be carrying out the mock drills once in 6 months or once in a quarter as deemed fit. Please participate actively. They are for our benefit, they are for our good, they are for our welfare. Secondly, you have been issued with the mess cards. Those who have not been issued will be issued shortly. And there will be an identity card also. They are non-transferable. Please do not give it to others. They are for your use, for your benefit. Do not transfer these benefits to others. You will be issued with a large number of keys. Please do not lose them. Losing of keys has two aspects. Firstly, you have forgotten it. Secondly, somebody has stolen it. If you feel somebody has stolen the keys, be overcautious about it. Whenever you exit and enter the hostels, please make an entry to that effect. It is for our accountable purposes that such an entry is required, so that in case of an emergency, we can trace you. Do not litter garbage all around, and do not also walk and eat. If you want to have some snacks and all, kindly sit down, have the snacks, put the litter in the garbage, and then move around. Moving and eating is a bad form of etiquette. Because of this littering, you will also find that at times there will be a dog menace, or dogs are going around the countryside, or there have been instances of monkey menace also, basically because of the food items. Our university is a no-smoking zone, and therefore please be prohibited. Do not try to have outside food. We have a large number of food outlets. However, if you are not satisfied with it, kindly give your feedback, we will change the menu, but try to avoid outside food. Do not keep any valuables with you. If any, please send them back to your parents. Please do not share your ATM passwords with each other. At times, presuming that you are in a hurry, you try to exchange the ATM pin codes and passwords, which at a later stage are counterproductive. The whole area is under electronic surveillance. Please be cautious. We have a lost and found desk. Anything found, please deposit it there. Whenever anything is deposited, you will receive a mail on your Outlook. Please collect your items from the lost and found desk in the security block. The villages and area around is slightly rustic in their environment. It may not be advisable for all of us to go there, especially so after the sunset. Please do not move into the villages. If there is a very, very important thing to be done in the nearby village known as Dehemikala, please move in larger groups during night. The liquor shop in and around the area is a prohibited area or an out-of-bound area. Please do not visit. Movement of girls into the boys' hostel and boys into the girls' hostel is not allowed. Please do not tamper with the fire equipment and the fire prevention equipment. It is for our benefit and a large number of equipments are lying here. Please do not tamper with it, because in case of an emergency, we'll require it. If you tamper with it, false emergencies will be raised and actual emergencies may not be identified. Do not damage or deface the hostel and the university property. You may be charged for it. In case of sickness, please report immediately to the medical center. If we find that the medical sickness is beyond the level of the medical sickness, you will be moved to the hospital where we are having our tie-up. Nothing more. Thanks a lot.
Us, Professor Uday Kumar Yaragetti, as our chief guest for today's orientation program. He is Director MNIT Jaipur and Chairman CSAB 2017. He also has served as in charge director of NIT Goa, and presently he is in charge director of IIIT Kota, an electrical engineer with specialization in power electronics and smart grid. He has done his PG from NITK Suratkal and PhD from IIT Mumbai. May I now invite our guest to address you all. Please, sir.
Thank you, respected Mr. Professor Sandeep Sancheti, my guru and my mentor, all the dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, all the would-be engineering kids. Wake up, man. I'm seeing for the last 2 hours you are so gloomy. The outside atmosphere is also gloomy, you are also gloomy. I think two of the faculty tried to energize you. Are you energized? Or you are feeling bad that mama, papa ke ghar chod ke dusre jagah, unknown place, alien place mein aa rahe ho? Is it so? How many of you come by your choice?
Oh, good, very good. I thought your parents might have pushed you out. Chalo, ghar mein baith ke dabang banne se acha hai, bahubali ban jao technology ka. Theek hai? I saw some smart people taking photographs of the library when our professor from library were discussing. Looks to be studious from now only. I like students very much, you know. I think our MC Miss did not tell much about it. I was a chief warden for almost 4 years, handling 6,000 students in NITK Suratkal with 70 hostels. So I know nuss of you all people. I think there was a talk that your seniors were taking oath that we won't rag. The same should be from your side also, that you won't rag your seniors. Because you are so much brought up in a lordly way, you know. I've seen some people in the banks and some offices, without asking who is standing as a, just take up his pen, sorry guy, sign it and put it back. And the guy will be furious. Sala dekh lunga tumhe baad mein. He'll be your senior. But he can't touch you. Parents, I think you should be grateful and gratitude to your parents, you know, who have brought you up to this level. You are engineering your life till today. You are engineering your 10th standard, 11th standard, 12th standard, and of course your coaching and competitive exams. Now you have to engineer your technology. We have come to a place, a temple. I just wanted to begin with a statement, what do you want now? Everything what you want is being told by them. You have a luxury life, sophisticated life here. Khana chahiye to you don't have to put a WhatsApp and ask your friend, chalo udhar jayenge khana khane ke liye. That's readily available in front of you. Books are available in front of you. The research, the faculty, everything. Aapko kya chahiye abhi? You are really lucky compared to any of other institute students, you know. Especially my students in NITK or IIT students. It's not so easily available. But you are so lucky that everything is available at the fingertips. So you got everything. Now you have to get engineering and technology degree. Do you agree with me? Haan, arre yaar, book mujhe bhi laga hai, aapko bhi laga hoga shayad. And this is the life you will start now. If you wake up late in the morning, you are surely going to miss your breakfast. If you don't go to the mess in time, you are going to miss your lunch or dinner. This will be a daily habit now. So be prepared from now only. I think your parents who have brought you to this level, still they are above, they are sitting up there, hearing me. Parents, you forget about your child now. They are in the safe hands of Manipal University Jaipur. Unko mat tang mat karo phone karke. And you guys and girls, at least 1 week or 1 month you will be troubling your parents, because anyway you have that fool's box in your hand. Iske bare mein bol raha hu. Every time I'm sending message, waiting for them, troubling them and all. Parents, they will trouble you for 1 month. After that, aapko dhoondna padega mera beta ya beti kahan hai. I think it will be a big job for our Dr. Anil Singh. To answer their queries, parents' queries, mera beta phone hi nahi kar raha hai. Mera beti phone hi nahi kar raha hai. Because they will be so much involved with their other crowd, they'll forget the parents also. Haan ya na, still you are not energized. I think you are very sad because mama, papa ke chhod ke aa raha hai na tum log idhar. You are missing the brush with ready toothpaste early in the morning. Chalo beta, utho. दूध पियो, खाना खाओ, ब्रेकफास्ट करो, नहाओ, सो जाओ. Yes, is it that you are missing your parents? अरे कुछ तो एक्सप्रेशन दिखाओ. आर यू हैप्पी? Even I think your chief warden could not hear. He was asking to shout. You are not even clapping. No. It is that thing that happens. Yeah. Because I was wondering when they were telling so many things at your fingertips. Everything is ready with you. Ready food with you. Only thing is you have to work hard. You read all the quotes of Swami Vivekananda. Everything leads to learning, teaching, science and life. Now your life is learning, your religion is learning, your dream is learning, everything. Like there was slogan tha na, kya hai? I can eat cricket, sleep cricket, drink cricket. Now learning should be your slogan. Sleep learning, drink learning, see learning, dream learning. अरे यार इधर चार साल पिकनिक बनाने नहीं आए हो तुम लोग. You have come to study. You have to do tapasya, meditation and medication of engineering and technology. You have to study by yourself. You have all the majestic professors of different field with you to help you, but interest has to be shown by you all guys and girls. You have all the sports facilities. Try to play, I am telling, because what happens, those who are interested, not playing on your mobile is not to play sports. Mobile is for the communication. The person who invented mobile, I think his soul will not rest in peace at all. That's what he has told. अरे मैंने ये क्या monster create किया? It's biting everybody back. So try to do. I think I was asking Professor Sanjay, do you have a book bank facility? He said no, but I saw there 15 days the books are given from the library. But I doubt how many of you read books. Everything is in your fingertips, but have a habit of reading books. At least have a habit of reading newspaper, only the front page. Don't go to the third page. You will know the latest what's happening in country, in the world. Join with the world, join with the humanity. Single you can just say, together you have to talk. Single you can enjoy, but together you will be celebrating. Individually single you are only smiling. When you are together you laugh. So you join the Manipal University Jaipur family. You are the family to that now, new member. Get connected yourself to MUJ and the full engineering faculty. Come up with high laurels. Do innovative things. Don't waste time on faltu things. You know what's a faltu things. Because only 4 years are left for your profession now. Till PUC or your 12th standard, I said mama, papa's boys, now it is your life. Because these are the 4 golden years, you will never get it back. Take advantage of this 4 years so that you won't regret later. All my friends, you know, even though they have done M.Tech, PhD or high profile learning, they still remember these 4 years of your engineering technology system. Parents, forget about your children. You don't have to worry about them. Even I have my child here. As a parent, I am worried inside, but I am academician, I know how the engineering colleges, institutes work. So don't be troubling them, don't worry about them. They will come with high laurels, they will bring name to you. And finally, students, do good job, hard work, bring name to your parents, your grandparents, your family, your school, your teachers and your alma mater. Thank you sir, thank you.
faculty of MUJ for giving me this opportunity. Goodbye, good luck, Jai.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging words. As we come to the end of this orientation program, I request Dean Faculty of Arts and Law, Professor Mridul Srivastav, to propose the vote of thanks.
Honorable Professor Uday Kumar, Director MNIT, Professor Sandeep Sancheti, Pro President Professor N.N. Sharma, our most valued deans, directors, students, and parents. It's a privilege for me to propose a vote of thanks on this most important occasion of welcoming our new batch of 2017. The entire Manipal group, with Manipal University Jaipur in particular, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to respected Dr. Ramdas M. Pai, Padma Bhushan awardee, Dr. K. Ramnarayan, Chairperson, Manipal University Jaipur, Dr. Ranjan R. Pai, CEO and MD, and the Board of Management for the constant support that they have provided to MUJ at all times. Leaders of Manipal Group, we are truly inspired by your deep thought insights and assure our focus on transform life by empowering life. Let me express my gratitude to our President for his able guidance, initiative and support. Sir, this university is constantly growing and progressing towards excellence under your dynamic leadership. Professor B.K. Sharma, Professor Apreesh Kumar, Professor Neelanjan, Professor Vandana Suhar, and Professor Rajesh Mathur, who richly deserves the gratitude, and I offer the same. Dear students, I am sure you and your parents have received a lot of rich inputs and inspiration from them today. I take this opportunity to deeply appreciate Chief Administrative Officer and his team, Professor in Charge Academics and his team, Head IT Infrastructure and his team, Proctor, Chief Warden and his team, Chief PRO and HODs for their tireless efforts and making this occasion a success. Respected guests, we have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very motivated and dedicated colleagues. Each one of them has worked hard day and night for the occasion. We are also thankful for the tremendous support given by Manipal Integrated Services for food arrangements, hostel and logistic support. The team have been result-oriented and has been dedicatedly putting efforts. The success of the program we see today is due to their deep involvement. I cannot thank them enough for their willingness to take on the completion of tasks beyond their comfort zones. We all have witnessed their hard work. Thank you, Team MIS. I hereby acknowledge and express our sincere thanks to the services of Manipal Health Enterprise, Manipal Hospital in particular, for monitoring the health of each one of us. It's an opportunity to express our deep sense of appreciation to press and media, which plays an important role in showcasing our activities, and also police, firefighting personnel for their support and cooperation. Our special thanks to Director Admissions, Dr. Richa Arora, and sincere thanks to our Master of Ceremony, Dr. Neetu Bhutnagar. Dear colleagues, student council, volunteers, and all of their association also deserves appreciation for their diligent efforts. We express our heartfelt thanks to all the parents for reposing their trust in Manipal University, Jaipur. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored to accept the responsibility of your wards. The student will go home for 2 months in a year, and for the remaining period that they are with us, we assure you that they will be given utmost care and consideration, just like our own children. Leading a learner to learning gives the teacher an untold pleasure. Dear parents, your presence here today gives us an opportunity to affirm the same. Thanks for sparing time to be with us on this day, which is one of the significant process before the commencement of new session. Entire team of Manipal University Jaipur heartily welcomes all the students of 2017 batch who have already demonstrated their winning attitude by qualifying in our entry level process, and I am sure
you are ready to go and receive further accolades. Today we believe is the turning point of your lives. Welcome to the Manipal Group and its ecosystem. Thank you all present and all the very best to the best of 2017. Thank you, Jai Hind.
Thank you, madam. With this, we come to the end of this orientation program. But before we leave, here are some important information for the parents and students. The proceedings of today's program is being hosted on MUJA website, which will be available from tomorrow. In case if you have missed anything of today's program, you can visit our website. The faculty members and MUJA leadership is available for interaction till 4 p.m. today. In case you want to meet them or you have any query, you can meet them either here or at the food court. Students and parents may visit departments and facilities of their interest, including the hostel areas, library, gym, etc. from 2 p.m. onwards. I now request students and parents to proceed for lunch, which has been arranged at the new food court towards the hostel. Thank you, one and all.